Good morning, students. Today we are going to learn about chemistry and the topic name is gases in the air around us. We know that air is a mixture of gases. Which gas is the most abundant in our atmosphere? Can you guess? Okay. So, air is a mixture of different gases such as, you know, nitrogen, oxygen, etc. So, today we are going to learn about most abundant in our atmosphere, that is important gas nitrogen. So nitrogen is the most abundant gas and contributes about 78% to our atmosphere. Before you learn about nitrogen, you just learn some keywords about this lesson: catalyst, nucleic acid, oxide and sodium nitrate. Do you know the history of nitrogen? Yes, it was discovered in 1772 by Daniel Rutherford in Scotland. Now, you have to learn about the physical properties of nitrogen. And it is a colorless, odorless and tasteless gas. That means, you know, odor means smell. And okay, color and tasteless gas. And in liquefies and solidifies at very low temperature. And in normal atmospheric pressure, nitrogen liquefies at 195.8 degrees Celsius, and solidifies or freezes at 209.86 degrees Celsius. It looks like water in liquid form and as white as ice in its solid form. It is non-combustible and does not support combustion, and it is partially soluble in water. It is a neutral, because which means neither acid nor basic, and does not change the color of litmus paper. So, as I already told you, discovered by Daniel Rutherford in 1772, and it is most abundant element in the universe, and it is the largest used in ammonia. And it is and also they given the atomic number is 7 and symbol is N, and what is the weight and the radius. These are that properties of nitrogen. And you have to know about the uses of nitrogen also. It is mostly used to fill aircraft and some vehicle tires. Other uses for the element or in steel production, and it is giving the high voltage. Nitrogen is an important component of plant and animal protein, so it is used to prepare fertilizers for plants. In chemical industries, nitrogen is used to produce ammonia. It is an essential compound in many industrial processes. And for example, it is used to produce rubber, nylon, dyes, explosives. These are that, okay. And nitrogen does not react with most of the elements. It helps to create an atmosphere, inert atmosphere for certain chemical reactions. In food industry, nitrogen gas is used to fill food packets. And it is safe, that means looks better, it keeps taste and allows transportation. And it is very useful for automobiles and aircrafts. In the medical field, blood, bone marrow, tissues and the bacteria are preserved or frozen with the help of liquid nitrogen. And liquid nitrogen is also used in refrigerator systems. And also you have to know about the chemical properties of nitrogen. Nitrogen only reacts with the other elements at a high temperature and pressure or in the presence of a catalyst. So reaction, that nitrogen, it is reaction with metals to produce their corresponding metal nitrates. So metal plus nitrogen, it gives metal nitrate. I give you one example, look at the picture. Magnesium plus nitrogen gives magnesium nitrate. And also that particular nitrogen, it is react with non-metals. Because oxygen and hydrogen to produce nitrogen compound. Okay, so non-metal plus oxygen gives non-metal nitrate oxide. I give you one example also. Hydrogen plus nitrogen gives ammonia. Okay, that means non-metal nitrate oxide. So in this block, we observe that nitrogen is colorless and odorless. and blows out a glowing splint, which indicates that it is neither combustible nor does it support combustion. Another property of nitrogen is that it is tasteless gas. Nitrogen is generally an unreactive gas at room temperature. It reacts at a special temperature or pressure. Nitrogen reacts with metals like calcium to produce metal nitrates. It reacts with non-metals like oxygen to produce different oxides of nitrogen and with hydrogen to produce ammonia. So, nitrogen is used for filling fresh food packets. It helps in preserving food because, you know, I asked you one question. What does this show about the property of nitrogen? Where else can nitrogen be used because of this property? Okay, this shows that nitrogen does not react easily with the other elements in normal conditions. Okay, so I hope you all understood about nitrogen. Thank you, students.